It was reported that OSP's team plans to file an appeal about the outcome of the Tanner Bozeman fight with following argument that Tanner Bozeman, one, grabbed the fence. Two, OSP is saying that the referee put his hands on his back, meaning OSP's, which is only done to stop the fight or halt the action, at which point OSP did stop and the tide turned. Now, I will admit, I have to rewatch this, but I would like to hear from you guys, because if the fence grab happened, I suppose we could see it. I did not see it. When it happened, I didn't see it. There's further review when you go back and look, and I'm not saying it didn't happen if you're saying it did. Okay, I didn't see it. I've only seen this thing once. I also did not see the referee put his hands on his back, but I absolutely was not looking for it. I could have been looking right at that and still not seen it, right? I mean, I know my eyes and I know the way I watched the fight. OSP has a major claim on the latter. If the referee touched him, that does signify one of two things: stopping the fight or a halt in the action. You are expressly told to stop when the referee stops you. In fact, you're told to stop for nothing else, which includes the horn. You've heard the term, of course, protect yourselves at all times. Just to share with you where that comes from. 1988, Seoul, Korea, Olympic Games. Boxing. Boxing in the Olympics, don't forget, is a tournament. Even though boxers fight 2 to 3 times and now as a pro, at one point in their life, they were actual tough guys and they could do it repeatedly over the course of a week, known as a tournament, known as the Olympics. So because you've got to run all these weight classes, you've got so many matches, you have three rings set up at one time, right? No different than a wrestling tournament where you're going to have three mats going and it's a tournament and guys are going and it's chaos and you're keeping track of the brackets and keeping score and send it off to the bracket room when it's done. Well, in one of the matches, the gold medal favorite, a horn went off. I believe it was the form of a whistle back then, before we even did horns. But the whistle blew. The gold medal favorite stopped boxing. The guy, his opponent, threw a hook and knocked him out cold. It was a whistle. He's right. But it was from the ring over. It was not in his ring, which is where the term protect yourself at all times and do not stop on the horn or the whistle. You stop when I stop you. That's where that comes from. And this goes both ways. We've seen guys knock somebody down and then follow up with a punch when they're clearly out cold. We've seen guys hold something a little bit too long. We've seen some of these things, and the guys will always tell their story after the fact, which is, I did not stop when he tapped. I did not stop when the horn went off. But the second the referee told me to stop, by putting his hands on me, boom, I released the hold. I quit punching. And those guys are never reviewed and there's no investigation done and there's no fines. There's no holding up or suspension of the license because they're right. That is what we are expressly told. So I only bring that to you because I've never seen it go this way. And I can't confirm for you that it happened, right? Sometimes weird things happen in a fight. You guys remember Overeem versus Miocic? And Overeem had a guillotine. And after the fight, Overeem told Joe Rogan, I felt him tap. I had the guillotine and he tapped. Now, Reem wasn't lying. Reem thought that that happened for whatever reason. Wherever he felt that, however he thought that it happened, he believed it. So Rogan throws it up. It's on the big screen. He goes, show me where he tapped. And they replay the position and Reem looks at it. And Reem tells the truth. And he goes, I guess he didn't. But there was no tomfoolery in that. Reem was telling his truth at the time. He was confronted with other evidence. He realizes the emperor has no clothes. He lets the whole thing go. But it's been over a day. I mean, it's been a good 36 hours. I am going to suspect and trust that OSP has gone back, has looked at the footage, and has some kind of evidence. Look, this is an interesting one. It's very rare that something gets turned over. But he's looking for something to happen. And I believe if the referee stepped in and put his hands on him and OSP stopped and he can show that, I think this has legs.